discussion is first and follow computation. Today the topic of discussion is first and follow computation. The name itself indicates first stands for first. For example, who is the first letter of, or what is the first letter of this sentence? T. You used to say T. Who is followed by T? You will say O. If I ask which is the first letter of this sentence, you will say B. Who is followed by B? You will say T. If I ask rather who is followed by P, you will tell A. Who is followed by N? You will tell G. You may look that it is kiddish, but it's fine. This is the concept we are going to look at with respect to grammar. This is with respect to English language, so you feel comfortable. Now we are going to find out first and follow with respect to CFG. The philosophy behind of first and follow computation is as simple like this only, but little bit technical perspective we may need to add. That is the only difference. So if I say who is the follower of W, you will say N. One more perspective you should remember. Who is the follower of N? You should say space, empty. If it is English, you will say space. If it is technical, you should say epsilon or empty. Who is the follower of G? If I ask, you should say it is empty, not even space. You should always use the word empty. Who is the follower of P? You should say empty. Who is the follower of M? You should say empty. Who is the follower of P? Empty. Follower of G? Empty. That's all. These are all the ground rules you should remember in your mind. One is the moment I ask first means within the production you are going to look at first. The moment I ask follow means who is followed by that fellow. That's it. If there are some symbol followed by, you need to consider that symbol. If there is a space or epsilon either with respect to context-free grammar, you should say epsilon or empty. That's all. These are all the ground rules you may need to consider before proceeding with first and follow. This is one of the important concepts in GATE examination as well, all the competitive examination as well. So today I'm going to invest only on first and follow computation. I will teach one problem slowly, steadily. Subsequently, we are going to solve 6 problems. Whichever is possible today, we will solve. Rest all, you need to take it as a homework. You need to come out with answer. With this notion, let me proceed further for the first and follow computation. This is the set of rules you need to consider. Right now it is not required. Directly I can enable you to learn through example. Look at, this is the given grammar. This grammar also obtained based on elimination of left recursion, elimination of left factor, elimination of ambiguity. All those things are eliminated already. It's free from these all the hazards. After the elimination of all those 3 things, this grammar have been obtained. During your homework exercise, I will give you a grammar to convert, or assignment time I will give few grammar to eliminate these all. By the time you can able to understand these all. Already I taught you step by step how to eliminate left recursion alone, how to eliminate left factoring alone, how to eliminate ambiguity alone. If you would have missed on that class, you can watch video which is released on YouTube. Now, using these all step by step procedure only, the computer arithmetic expression evaluation grammar has been converted into ambiguous free. This is the grammar after the elimination of all the 3 hazardous occurrences. These are all the 3 systems can be said as non-deterministic or hazardous. Those all are removed. After removal, assuming that this is the grammar given in your question paper, you have got perfect grammar. If you analyze this grammar, you will have only one leftmost derivation, only one rightmost derivation. that itself is the indication it is free from ambiguity, it is free from factoring, it is free from recursion. This is called left factoring. So this, all those three things has been removed, I can guarantee. With that approach, let us proceed. Already I said, these are all the three stuff need to be eliminated before proceeding with predictive parsing table construction. In order to construct a predictive parsing table, the very first requisite, prerequisite is first and follow computation. In order to compute follow, first is essential. So that we are going to first computation for this grammar. Let me move this grammar to the next page so that we can look at all at a time. We can work on this computation. Now, I will compute one grammar at a time. Then we can look at the answer. See, these are all the answers. Again, these are all the answers. Let us see how I am computing first. For this grammar, I am computing first of this grammar. First is equal to, I am writing. The moment I write first is, I am intended to compute first of this grammar. Please look at carefully. Before that, let me copy this epsilon for my convenience. Now, look at this. What is the meaning of first is, we are going to compute first for E. Look at, in this production, who is sitting on the left hand side? LHS E. That is why I am computing first of E. When it comes to second grammar, I need to compute first of E dash. E dash. Now, how I am going to compute? Let us see. First, let me write what are all the first we are going to compute. For the next grammar, what is the LHS? LHS is T. So that I supposed to compute first for capital T, that is non-terminal. Then in this grammar, I supposed to compute first of T dash. So because T dash only available on the LHS. T dash. So that I supposed to compute follow of T. Now, next step, I need to compute first of F, because F only available on the left hand side, LHS of the production, it is non-terminal. Now, the what we supposed to do, I have done. Now, first step, we are going to find out first for this E, so that I have opened this function. This is a function, first of E. In the flower bracket, I'm going to write all the first of E. Now you may need to pay your full attention how I am going to compute first of E. Look at, in this production, who is the first symbol of E is this fellow. T is the first symbol of E. I'll put it in different mark, you can able to understand. This is the person first of E. First of E is capital T. If the first symbol is non-terminal, your duty is to take a jump or to visit the T production. Now, we looked into first symbol of E. It happens to become non-terminal T. Since it is non-terminal, we are taking a jump to this production. Here, we are going to look at the first of T. First of T is also a non-terminal. Now, no other go. We need to take a jump or visit to the production F. Now, we reached the production F. The first of F is this symbol. The first of F is, you are fortunate, open bracket. You can harvest this symbol, open bracket, comma. Next, F is a production, has one more symbol as well, ID. ID, not two different symbol. This is a single symbol. So I need to harvest this symbol as well. So that first of E is open bracket and small id over. I am done with first computation for this symbol E. If you have got doubt, you can ping me in the chat box. If not, let me proceed. Otherwise also just hold, let me complete all the first computation. Now we are moving on to the second production, E dash. Now our duty is to compute first for E dash. I need to look at all its production. E dash have got two productions. It has one production of this form. It has another production of this form. Let me look into the first production. If I look at the first production, who is the first symbol? Plus. Luckily, plus is terminal. No more work for me. I am going to write plus as such. If I look at second production, the first symbol, one and only the symbol. So that also epsilon, empty. I need to consider thus that epsilon as such. Now this production also have got over. Now we are going to compute first of t. Let me open the flower bracket. Now in this first of t, I'm looking at the first symbol of the t production. Little bit of unfortunate, it is not terminal. Since it is not terminal, I need to visit the production f. If I visit production f, who is my first symbol of first production? Open bracket. Who is the second symbol of alternate production? Id. So I'm going to harvest open bracket comma id, small id over. Now I need to look at the second production, so alternate, that subsequent production t dash. If I look at t dash, it has two different production. The very first production, I need to look at the first symbol. We are fortunate, the first symbol is terminal. So I can harvest star as such. I can collect star, comma. Next is alternate production I need to look at. This has epsilon. I need to write as such the epsilon. That's all. Now we are coming to the last production F. I need to look at the first symbol of all its alternatives. The first symbol of this production happens to become open bracket. The first symbol of alternate production is ID over. Now, what I am doing in simple terms, I'm going to give you a recap. What I was trying to do is, for every symbol, every non-terminal of the production, each and every non-terminal of the production, remember, I'm trying to compute first. There are five non-terminals in this grammar given CFG. The very first non-terminal is E. So I'm trying to compute first of E. Second non-terminal is E dash. So I'm trying to compute E dash, first of E dash. Third non-terminal is T. I'm trying to compute first of T. Fourth non-terminal is T dash. I'm trying to compute T dash or first of T dash. Last non-terminal is F. I'm trying to compute first of F. This is the first step you should remember and understand. Hope with that notion, I am moving on to the next step. Whenever you look at first of any non-terminal, if it happens to become non-terminal once again, you need to take to that production. You need to move to that production. In that production, if it happens to become non-terminal again, you need to revisit or you need to visit that production. Whenever you are trying to find out first of any non-terminal, if it happens to become terminals, simple harvesting, simple collection, that's it. If you look at E dash, epsilon is also considered as terminal. Plus is also considered as terminal. Star is all the operators are terminal. Epsilon is terminal. This is parenthesis, punctuation operator. This parenthesis operator, so it is terminal. ID is terminal. That's it. Very simple. First computation, you no need to put your effort a lot. To whom you need to find out first? For all the non-terminals, you need to find out first. Subsequently, you need to look at the first symbol of the production. If it is non-terminal, you need to visit that production. If it is terminal, simple collection. If it is again non-terminal, you need to visit that production. Luckily, you have got two terminals for F. So you need to fill the terminals of F to first of E, because the first happened to become T, T's first happened to become F, F's first to only open bracket ID. It doesn't matter. Although you collect from F, it doesn't matter. This is a sequence you need to follow so that you are filling this symbol. Next, E dash. You are fortunate, you are lucky. Both the production has terminal as the first symbol, so I have written down. If you look at this production, the first symbol happened to become non-terminal. Since it is non-terminal, I need to take a jump to the last production. I need to look at the first symbol of this F, so it happens to become open bracket and ID. I need to fill back to this T, open bracket and ID. I'm looking at T dash production. The first symbol of T dash is star and epsilon. I am fortunate and lucky. It is terminal, so I have collected. When I visit F, again I am fortunate. The first symbol of F is open bracket and ID. I have collected here. This is how first computation will take place. I can say this is very simplest grammar. You can do like this. There is little more complex grammar. I'll come back to that. You may need to learn further few more steps in first computation, but this is essential and vital for understanding first computation. Now I ask to you all, do you have any doubts on first computation? Either you can unmute and question me, or you can chat with me, so that if you feel confident, I can move on to the follow computation. First is essential for follow finding, so that I'm preferring to do first computation. Subsequently, I'm going to do follow computation for the same grammar. Guys, open up your mind. If you have got doubt, you just communicate to me. Then and there you need to eradicate your doubts, because everything which I'm going to deal here afterwards interdependent. This first computation helps for follow computation. Both first and follow will help you for designing the parse table. The parse table is helpful for parsing action. So if anything goes wrong, everything will go wrong. So although you put effort, you will get 0 mark in your examination. You need to perfectly compute first. Once if you have computed perfectly first, then you need to go for follow computation. If both are perfect only, your parse table will become perfect. If your parse table becomes perfect only, your parsing action will become perfect. So remember this. If you have got doubt, you can question me, or else the same video I'll be releasing on the YouTube. You can watch. That's it. Now let us move on to follow computation. The same I'm going to rewrite once again beneath this. I'm changing the material, flow of material, because this is how I can teach. So now I'm going for follow computation. Follow computation is also going to become the same. First, I need to make this to become empty, because follow symbols would become different. So I'm going to erase all the first symbols. Next, I need to change all the first by follow. These are all the few steps I'm doing, just for the same symbols only you need to retain for follow computation. Guys, remember, there is no more symbols. All the non-terminals we need to find out follow. I'm going to just replace the name of the function first by follow. So once if you know first computation, follow will become easier. Hope so you don't have any doubt on it. What way I have written for first computation, similar manner only I'm trying to write here. So now let us look into this production. Now I'm going to apply black and the normal representation, so that whenever I collect, you can able to understand what is the significant change I'm trying to do here. So let me complete this cleaning process, then I'll proceed. Give me a minute. Yes, we are ready now. Let us go for follow computation. What I am doing, how I am doing, you need to pay a lot of attention than first. For follow is, I myself can say, bit complicated. First is easier for you. Now, look at, among all the productions, E is said to be starting production or E is said to be start symbol. In a given CFG, for the start production, close your eyes, blindly you need to put dollar. No more question, no more argument. You need to find out the start symbol of the given CFG, whichever may be the start symbol, for that symbol, you need to include dollar into the follow computation. Blindly, you need to do this step. No more question. Why? You will come to know during parse table construction or parsing action why I am doing this. Right now, it is a bit early to explain you why I am including this dollar symbol. This also I mentioned during the parse table, that the parser block diagram, by the time I have articulated, dollar is a symbol included in the input buffer. Dollar is the symbol included in the stack also. There are two data structures are involved in parsing action, input buffer and the stack architecture, stack data structure. So both of the data structures are filled with dollar. That is why we are here including dollar. That justification also I have articulated. Since this is the start symbol of the production, blindly I am adding dollar. That question is over. Now let us move to follow computation. Please pay your attention, sail with me carefully. Look at on the RHS of all the production, where E is available. Here is the only place E is available. This is the only place I am having E. Look at, no more production has E on the right hand side. Please understand and perceive what I am trying to tell. This is the only one place E is available. Although I am working on this production, I need to look at into the entire CFG. Entire CFG, if I walk through, only in this instance or in this place, I am having E, capital E. Now our duty is to do follow. Who is followed by E? Look at close bracket. This fellow is a terminal. So no more argument. Simply we can include this open bracket. We are done with the follow computation of E. That's it. Follow of E over. Follow of E, E is the start symbol. Just because of the start symbol, I have included dollar symbol. I need to look at among all the productions in the given CFG, where E is available. I need to find out that exact spot. It is available in the last production. I am just marking in my mind where E is available. I'm just looking at who is followed by this E. E is followed by open bracket. It is terminal. Because of that, I'm just harvesting and collecting into follow. Guys, hope you would be understanding what I'm trying to tell. Over. Follow computation of E have got over. Now I am moving to follow computation of E dash. So if I am trying to do follow computation of E dash, what I am going to do, let us see. Look at again where E dash is available. First, spot it out. You need to spot that availability of E dash in your mind. I am just spotting because of teaching. I am just spotting all the availability of E dash. Only these are all the two circumstances I am having E dash. So when there are two places E dash is available, what you supposed to do? You need to just do union. Union of first E dash and second E dash. Let me tell you how we are going to do. Look at, follow of E dash is empty. Nothing is available. Look at this E dash is also. Follow of E dash is empty. Nothing is available. In this case, what I supposed to do? I am coming to second rule of follow computation. When the non-terminal followed by empty, you need to include the as such follow of this LHS. You need to include the complete follow of this person. Since E dash is followed by MT, I need to look at the LHS. Whatever may be the follow of this person, I need to include. Yes, I have follow for E dash. Just now I have computed. This is the follow for E dash. So I can write as such. Now, coming to this scenario, E dash is followed by MT. Then I need to include follow of E dash. Since these two symbols are same, I no need to do. It is waste of time, duplication. So I am just eliminating. Although rule says union of follow of this and this. This is E dash is produces E dash. No more excitement. So I am avoiding. So E dash followed by MT. Because of that, I am including follow of E. So I need to include dollar symbol, comma, close bracket. As per the rule of follow computation. Guys, are you able to remember or understand what I am trying to speak? The way in which I did follow for this is different. The way in which follow I did for this is different. So there are few more rules also available for follow. If you have any questions, you can ping me in the chat box or unmute yourself. If not, I'll be keep on proceeding. Now, I am moving on to follow computation of T. First, my prime duty is to locate where T is available. I am going to locate this fellow. Now this T is available here. I'm going to put much more bigger because my duty is to find out follow of this fellow T. There is a one more T is also available. Look at, there are two different T's available. What I supposed to do? Union of that only we should do. Now look at how I am going to do. It is little bit different. This is third rule of follow. This is first rule, this is second rule. Now I am going to third rule. Please listen carefully. Now who is followed by T? Another non-terminal. Neither it is terminal nor it is non-terminal. It is empty, nor it is empty. It is non-terminal. See, we have seen two circumstances. One is followed by terminal, we have seen. Another one is followed by empty, we have seen. Now this is third scenario. Please understand. T is followed by non-terminal. This is also non-terminal, capital T, followed by non-terminal. Now, how I can do follow of T is my question. In this scenario, who is followed by T? Both the circumstances, it is E dash. So I need to go to E dash. I need to copy paste this plus. I need to do first. I need to go to first. Listen carefully. I'm going that this is the first time I'm looking into first. First of T has, sorry, E dash. First of T dash has plus and epsilon. Let me include plus first. Next, first of E dash is having epsilon. I need not including that plus. I am going to substitute in this place of E dash. I need to substitute plus in this place of E dash. I need to substitute plus. Then naturally, who will be followed by T? Plus plus. That is why I have included plus, nothing more. Now, first of E dash, there is one more terminal, sorry, one more collection. That epsilon I need to substitute in place of this E dash and in place of this E dash. Then what would become your E dash? This term will become empty. Then T is followed by who? Empty. T is followed by who? Empty. Because of that emptiness, we need to include follow of this person, follow of this person. If you look at, both of the follows are same. So I'm going to include comma dollar comma close bracket. That's it. This is how you need to compute follow. Only three rules. Starting symbol, dollar, you need to include. If follow is terminal, you need to write as such. If the follow is non-terminal, you need to collect the first. The entire first symbol you need to substitute each and every time. Whichever the terminal comes, you can write. If it happens to become epsilon, then you need to go for empty. Just because of empty, you need to include left hand side follow as such. That's all. Now we are going to follow computation of t dash. Look at t dash. This is I am locating in my mind. There are two places t dash are available. But if I look at t dash followed by what is available, t dash followed by empty, epsilon, nothing is available, t dash followed by empty, then what I supposed to do? As such, I need to include follow of this fellow. Then this is same symbol, no effect. So I'm going to include follow of t as such. Plus is one of the follow available in t. So plus, comma, dollar, comma, bracket. So follow of t, I have imitated because t dash followed by epsilon mt. Because of this emptiness, I am including follow of t. That's it. Now, the last step is computing follow of f. Please pay your attention. At least this time you need to understand what I'm trying to tell. I'll customize it back. Now I need to spot out where the F symbol is available. This is one place F is available. Look at 18 I'm going to put. This is F, another place F is available. Now, who is followed by T dot F? F is followed by T dash. In this circumstance, I need to look at first of T dash. Say T dash, I need to look at first of T dash. Imagine I am substituting this star wherever T dash is available. In both the places, I am going to put star star. Then who is followed by FF? Followed by star. Now, there is a second symbol in the T dash, that is epsilon. I'm going to substitute this epsilon for T dash and this T dash. Then naturally, F is followed by MT will happen. F is followed by MT will happen. Any non-terminal followed by MT comes, I need to blindly include follow of T. This is how so far now we are doing. So follow of T is having for either follow of T or T dash, both are same. So I can include plus symbol, comma, dollar, comma, close bracket. Now follow computation also I have demonstrated. First computation, follow computation, both are over. I just give you a pass for 1 minute. All of you please look into this, rehearse in your mind how I did first and follow for the given grammar. This is the grammar. Grammar itself is available. So rehearse on your mind how I did. If you have got doubt, I'll give you half a minute or 1 minute. Rehearse in your mind or walk through what I did, how I did. Any doubt comes, you please ping me in the chat box. Then we proceed to the second problem. Guys, do you have any doubts? If you have, you need to clarify then and there. Complete unit 3 is also dependent on first and follow. Please don't give up. If you have got doubt, clarify then and there. So entire unit 2, unit 3, this is a vital part for any parse table construction. It is interdependent. So many topics you are going to learn on this. It is not only a standalone topic, first and follow computation. This is the base for most of the parser design, parsing table construction, parsing action, both laboratory and theory. Now, directly I am moving on to few more problems to be solved. Now let us consider, these are the five grammar. You guys need to tell me what is the first of first production, first of yes I am writing. I don't write every time. Now you need to consider first of S, first of A, first of B. First you need to type. I am giving you a minute or half a minute. You need to type first of yes. Come on, start first of yes. Use the chat box, first of S, write out. What is first of S? Guys, are you there? First of capital S. Could you able to hear me? Anyone unmute yourself, first say whether you are present or not. Whether internet is available or not, first unmute yourself and acknowledge first. Guys, anyone is there? Pontej, are you there? Pallavi, are you there? Pallavi, Pontej, are you there? Very good. G5. Excellent. First of S is A. That's it. Because it is terminal. You are lucky. First of S is A. Open bracket. A. Over. See. Now, I have answer. Later on, I'll show you. Now, you need to tell me first of capital A. First of capital A. G5, excellent. At least take part forthcoming discussion also. First of capital A. Just give answer alone. First of capital A. Come on guys, make it fast. At least two problems I need to solve. Only 9 more minutes. Excellent. E naught, excellent. C comma epsilon. See, C is the terminal. C, epsilon I have copied, I am pasting. C comma epsilon is the first of capital A. Excellent. Now first of capital B. Anyone else? Or G5 E naught, anyone can give answer. First of capital B. Excellent. D comma epsilon E0 G6. Thank you, ma'am. D comma epsilon. Look at first of B is this fellow. He is a terminal. First of B is epsilon. This is also terminal. So D comma epsilon, C comma epsilon. Very good. Excellent. Let us walk through first for everything. Then follow tomorrow also we can do. Come on, quick. First of yes, do for this grammar. First of yes. Quick, quick, you need to give answer. That's why I will feel excited. See, listen, all the grammar we are going to look at first only today. No follow. First of yes. Super. That's all. Just don't format it. Past past, you respond to me. First of B. First of capital B. First of capital B. Come on, guys. Give me answer alone. Don't decorate. First of capital B. C, not capital C, small c. Yeah, that's fine. Small c. Typo error maybe. Now, first of capital C. First of capital C. Make it fast. B comma epsilon. Excellent. B comma epsilon. That's it. Now, you need to be more careful, guys. This is a new learning going to happen. First of D. Very interesting problem. This is, that's why I have collected. First of D. You need to do bit carefully. Take some time and give me answer. Some G2 and E0, G comma epsilon you have put. Yes, I agree. G, I need to put G. When I put epsilon, this term will go away. Then first of D is who? F. Your answer is bit wrong. This is a new learning. That's why I'm teaching you. Don't worry. Now see, I need to substitute. Don't rehearse in your mind. In your mind itself, you need to substitute. If I put E here, what would happen? D of first would become G. I agree. If I put this epsilon here, what would happen? First of D would become epsilon F. So that I need to include F comma epsilon as well. Do you have got any doubt, please? This is new learning. G2 and E0. Could you understand what I'm trying to tell? G comma epsilon, you said I agree. That G, if you put, that would become first. Then if I substitute epsilon, yes ma, good. That if I put epsilon, that epsilon if I substitute, this fellow will vanish. If this fellow vanished, then what would happen? Naturally, he would be the domineering person, F. Then I need to find out first of F. This is F. Then if I put epsilon, epsilon, that's it. Now tell me first of E. First of E, first of E, yeah, G comma epsilon. First of E is G comma epsilon. First of F, F comma epsilon. Very good. F comma epsilon. Now let us move on fast. Come on, quick. See, this is, this one alone, if you do, I can wind up the session. This is very toughest grammar. See, take lot of time and give me the answer. If we do in this session first of S alone, I'd be happy enough. Let us stop. You understood ultimate. First of S, if you do perfectly, you understood ultimate. Take time. Take 1 minute also. Let us do this first of S alone today. Let us stop the session. First of S, understand this is the concept again available here. Be careful. Then give me answer. Take your time. Very good. G2 have given ABC epsilon. Very good. G2. See, first of A, first of S is A. I need to go to this A production. Here small a is available. I need to replace here in my mind. Then it becomes A. Then if I replace this fellow epsilon, this A would be disappeared. It will vanish. Then B will be dominating. B is the first fellow. Then I substitute B. What would happen? B is my first. Then if I substitute C, this fellow also will disappear. Vanished. Now C will be domineering. Then C is dominated. Then I need to use small c as the first of this S. A, B, C, epsilon also will come. I think so. Yeah, epsilon will come. Yeah. Now, let us see the answers. C. Yes, epsilon will not come. A, B, C only. No epsilon. That is what I was doubted. No epsilon, because epsilon is getting cancelled. If I substitute here, 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 if C has epsilon, then I need to write. C doesn't have epsilon. I need to substitute. A I am substituting. What is the consequences? I have done. Then epsilon I am substituting. What is the consequences? I did the justice. Then B I am substituting. What is the consequences? I did the justice. Epsilon I am substituting. What is the consequences? I did the justice. Then if both will become empty, this person will take the lead. Then if this person takes the lead, who is the first person available? Only C. So if I put small c, C will become the first. No more epsilon. This is the another new kind of learning than this production. If you look at this production, EF, both productions have got epsilon, epsilon. Then if I put both for epsilon, output would become epsilon. No, that epsilon only I'm writing. But here the entire production never it vanishes. Please understand, there is a subtle difference between this and this. What we are doing, this and this, D and S, there is a subtle difference, although it imitates the same. Guys, could you able to understand what I'm trying to tell? Is it a G2? Is it clear, ma? Kanna, what I'm telling, can you able to understand? A, B, C. Yes, ma, that's it. Because no more epsilon available, so that only I'm doing. I'm just going to generate your attendance. If you have got doubt, you can clarify now. If not, let us proceed with the same problem statement tomorrow as well. We are going to complete all the 5 problems. Until you understand all the 5 problems, I will not proceed further. So nothing to worry.